1946, the Navy pulled into the harbor, the lagoon in Bikini, and went ashore and told the people there that the United States would like to use their atoll as testing a site for bombs, atomic bombs. This very direct approach was well rehearsed. The team that went there to quote-unquote seek the permission of the natives couched it in terms of something that was the will of God, that it was a call from God for the people of Bikini to sacrifice for the peace and security of the world. So the people left. Aniwita Atoll was also evacuated for the tests. While 67 devices were reportedly detonated in that period, the extent of the nuclear insult, for lack of a better word, the yield of those tests has been estimated at 1.7 Hiroshima shots every day for 12 years. We in the Marshalls, covering an area just under 1 million square miles of ocean, were the direct, like the ground zero, extended ground zero of the atomic bomb tests.
The largest explosion and still the most powerful nuclear device ever detonated by the U.S. took place March 1, 1954. Codenamed Bravo, it was a 15-megaton hydrogen bomb equivalent to 1,000 Hiroshimas. A miscalculation caused the yield to be about double what was expected. The radioactive fallout blew right onto two inhabited atolls downwind. More than 200 people were on those atolls, men, women, and children.
Wrong-lap is one of the four affected atolls by the nuclear testing of the United States from 1946 to the late 50s. The Wrong-lap is people, not only the land that has been contaminated from radiation, but their bodies and their health is also as affected from the fallout of March 1, 1954.
National Cancer Institute was asked to determine what kind of cancer burn was generated from the nuclear testing. And in 2004, they came out with a report that said, in the period of time between 1946 and 1958, the people who lived in the Marshall Islands during that time, it would have generated an excess of 530 excess cancers, at least, above the background. And half of those, over 200, because of they take a while to grow, have yet to produce themselves. So it's quite a heavy load.
As bad as the health effects of the testing were, the upheaval caused by the displacement of people from one island to another was even more damaging.
If you take a community away from its land and its lagoon, and you place them in another atoll, the fabric, the social fabric of that community is ripped apart.
The land is where it gives you the freedom to express yourself as you are, as a Marshallese person with your traditional culture.
When you move people off their islands where they live to do the testing, you break down their entire community structure. What is the impact on health? You know, the stress issues. You contaminate their lands. They can't grow things that they used to eat. When you urbanize, infectious diseases tend to take off. They get more diabetic because, you know, they're eating a Western diet. All those kinds of things, to me, have actually the larger impact than the ionizing radiation.